stop me then and there, so that I will repeat it again. I hope you people have watched the previous class video. Okay, good evening one and all again. So this is how an LGRAMMAR protocol system will look like, the structure of key generation, encryption and decryption. To start off with the key generation, we have a prime number called P, which will be chosen by the user. Okay, then we'll be choosing a value called E1, and we'll be choosing the private key called D. So with the help of P, E1 and D, I'll be creating another value called E2. Okay, so that the values of E1, E2 and P will become the public keys. So using this public key values, I will be able to generate a ciphertext. Whereas in LGRAMMAR system, I'll be creating two ciphertexts, C1 and C2. This is C2, but in the book, when I mentioned C1, there's a typo error in the book, so it is a C2 here. So C1 is nothing but a first version of ciphertext, which will be generated with help of the public key called E1. And here comes the unique part of LGRAMMAR system, which is R. This R is a secret key known one and only to the transmitter. This is the unique feature. This R is a secret. This R is a secret known one and only to the transmitter end. So based on this, I'll be creating the ciphertext C1. Then C2 is created with the E2, that is other value of a public key, raised to the power R, multiplied with the plain text under modulo P. Once you receive the ciphertext, that is C1 and C2, I can able to get the plain text back using this expression. That is C2 multiplied with C1 power D, the whole inverse. That is a multiplicative inverse of C1 power D, multiplied with C2 under modulo P, will give me the plain text back. So this is a general flow of an LGRAMMAR crypto system. So anyone have any doubts in this flow, you can ask me. If it is clear, kindly raise your hands. If it is clear, raise your hands. If you have any doubts in anywhere in this part, you can ask me. Thank you. What I just discussed here, and this is a proof of how your this decryption part. We said that C2 multiplied with C1 power D mod P. We know that C2 is nothing but E2 raised to power R and suffix P, and C1, we already know C1 is nothing but E1 power R mod P. So E1 power R is there. Again, it is raised to power D, so I'll be getting E1 power R D, the whole inverse. So that if you're in the decryption part, I can write this E2. We already generated this E2 as E1 power D mod P. I can write E2 as E1 power D. So I'll be getting E1 RD and again E1 RD whole inverse. So both will cancel each other. So then I'll get the plain text back. This is how your LGRAMMAR crypto system's decryption part works on. Right. Here for understanding purpose, we have used a very small digit numbers. For example, here if you see, prime number P is chosen to be 11, and we have our E1 to be 2 and D to be 3. So that they created E1 power D, E1 power D mod P. In this case, 8 mod 11 will give me 8. So that I got my public keys as 2, 8 and 11. And they choose the private key as 3 here. And here Alice is a transmitter who chooses a secret value as 4. And you can able to create the C1 and C2 using this expression. We got two expressions, 5 and 6 as C1 and C2. And in the plain text, they have computed it to be 7, which is nothing but the plain text we decrypted again. And in the decryption part, instead of going with C2 multiplied with C1 power D whole inverse, I can reframe it using Fermat-Smith theorem as C2 multiplied with C1 power P minus 1 minus D. Simplify 11 minus 1 minus 3, which will give me the value easily. So here you can able to see, in this case, if you are going with this method, there is no need to compute your multiplicative inverse. Directly you'll be getting the modulo operation easily. Right, so rest of the things we have discussed in the previous video itself. And analytic cryptography, this is the same thing whatever we discussed here. And I had given a brief introduction about this analytic cryptography in the previous class video itself. Now, this is how an ECC simulated LGRAMMAR will look like. What I mean is, the same LGRAMMAR system can be improvised if I able to introduce ECC, that is LP cryptography inside them. How in the sense, if you see in the previous LGRAMMAR, Here I'll be using a prime number called p. Instead, here I'll be using empty curve e suffix p a comma b, the same thing. Here we had used a point called e1 in example. Here this point e1 will be a point on the curve, that is it will have x and y coordinate. D will be an integer again, and e2 here is nothing but generated as d times e1, but some no modulo operation involved here. For example, d times e1 means I'll be adding e1 d times, like how we have done our addition. Like if I have 4p means you have to go with p plus. Same way you'll be doing the operation here to get the values of e2. So you'll be getting e1 as a point, e2 as a point, and ep as a elliptic curve. All this thing making a public key. Right. Using this and this secret tone one and only to a transmitter, I'm creating the two ciphertext c1 and c2. Whereas c1 is simply r times e1, and c2 is nothing but plain text which will be added with r times e2. And here the plain text will also have x and y coordinate here. And at the decryption end, you'll be going with c2 minus of d times c1. So you'll be computing d times c1, the point. Then you have to find, for example, you get the point, this one as x means, then minus means you have to compute minus x. Minus x will be anything but x comma minus y. How we have done finding the negative value of the point p, the same rule will be applied here to get the plain text back. This is how your ECC simulator example will look like. Right. So anyone have any doubts in this LGAML based, you can ask me. Otherwise, you can raise your hands. It is fine. Raise your hands. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Because the same description has been done in the previous video itself. So I don't want to repeat it again. So now I'll start off with an example. Before that, I want everyone to note down certain things. I'll just let you know. First, I want everyone. Note down the key generation part, list bots, okay, and the encryption and decryption part, so that will be helpful for you people for solving the numericals. I want you people to note down this bots, this, and this now itself. Once noted down, kindly raise your hand so that I'll move on to a slide of ECC simulated LGAML so that you can note those things also. Then we jump into a numerical for a clear description. I want everyone to note down the LGAML's key generation, encryption, and decryption. Once noted down the LGAML part, kindly raise your hands. Thank you, Ajay. Thank you. Okay. Okay, people have yet to note, at least take a screenshot or just take a pic kind of thing so that I'll move. Okay, now I'm moving on to note down these things also, because you should not get confused. So kindly have these things as parallel with you. That is, it is same thing, but since we are dealing with the times of points on the elliptic curve, the expression may look different. So I want everyone to note down this key generation part for ECC simulated LGAML, the encryption part, and the decryption part. Once noted, kindly raise your hands after noting EC simulated LGAML so that you jump into the numericals. Kindly note down this EC computer LGAML also along with your LGAML system, so that during your CAT or FAT, even if it is open book, it will be easy for you to refer. That's why having them to the same page. Thank you, Rishabh. I think you have noted down for both of them. People have noted down both the formulas. Can you rise? Yes, Ajay, you have noted down previously. Now also okay. Yeah. Thank you, Tisha. Thank you, Rishita. Okay. Now we move on, I think. So. Yeah. We'll take an example. Okay. ECC simulated L gamma system. Now Bob has selected the curve to be E suffix 63, 2 comma 3. So the value of P is 67 here, A and B are 2 and 3. Here we are not going to deal with any your elliptic curves equations here. Okay, this is nothing but your one of the public key. And he also chooses his E1 point to be 2 comma 22, which lies on this curve, and the private key to be D is equal to 4. So next step, we have to generate E2. We have to generate E2, which is nothing but D times E1. So in this example, I'll just guide you step by step. You can work it out the same example in your home. Okay. We also had the same discussion in your previous video itself, but still I want to discuss it again. So D is 4. So 4 times the point E1. It is like how we compute the 4 piece. So I'll be adding E1 point. Points in this example. So if you can't, I'll be getting the value of E2 to be 13,45. Now what your public keys, the elliptic curve E, E1 and E2. Okay. Suppose Alice want to send a plain text, which is a point 24,26, and she chooses her secret to be 2. Right. Now I have to compute C1 and C2. C1 is, what is C1? Can anyone tell? Unmute and tell. R times E1. Right. R times E1 gives me C1. This is 2. Value is 2,22. Okay. So while you are computing this E2 itself in this example, okay, so that they'll get the value of C1, and C2 is nothing but plain text plus R times E2, right? So plain text is a point and R times E2, so that here they found the values to be C1 as 35,1 and C2 to be 21,44. So in this step, we got your encrypted values. In this step, we got your all your public keys, right? And private key is already set to be 4. Yeah, right. Now for decryption part. For decryption part, the plain text is C2, right? Minus D times C1. So first I'll be computing D times C1. D is 4 here. So I'll go with 4 times the point C1, which is 35,1. Okay. Now I have to compute minus D times, means minus D times C1 is something, but the resultant which you get, you have to take X comma minus Y. You'll get this one. So D times C1, 4 into 35,1 will give me an answer as 23,25. Actually, I know I'm just saying the answers directly, but in examination, you have to compute, right? Suppose, assume this is point like A, means if I want minus A, which is nothing but minus D times C1, I have to go with 23, minus 25. If I want to convert this minus 25 into positive value, here the value of P is 67, you can able to see. So 67 minus 25 will give me 42, so that I'll get the final answer as 23,42 for my this part. Right, so 23,42 plus the C2 will give me the main text back. Right, so whatever we just discussed here is, has been said here, how we have got this one, and so that you'll be getting a plain text back. So this is how your ECC based LLM will work out. I want everyone to work it out. This point, actually, people will be working only with the reputation of points alone here. Nothing much from your elliptical, elliptical arithmetic is replaced here. Simply your reputation of points alone is a basic concept present here. Right. So is it clear? If it is clear, raise your hands. Or if you have any doubts, you can ask me. So what is the need of this ECC based schemes? Why you are introducing this ECC means, here it shows the comparison of key size. So if you go for normal symmetric key schemes, like your AES, DES, the key size are small compared to your asymmetric. Here they take an RSA for a comparison, RSA ecosystem. Okay, they are using 512 bits, 1024 maximum, they went for 15,360 bits. Okay. Whereas if you use ECC based assisted schemes, like your LVML, instead of 512, I can able to use 112. It's instead of 15,360, my 512 itself will do the job. So this is the major purpose of using this elliptical cryptography in this asymmetric key cryptography system. Okay. So before going into the numericals for LLM system, I'll complete the model with the final topic of pseudo random number generation. Then we jump into the final numerical tutorial. Then we'll wrap up today's session. Fine. So the last topic of this module 4 is your PN sequence generation, that is pseudo random number generation based on asymmetric ciphers. In last module, we have a discussion on symmetric ciphers, how symmetric ciphers can be utilized for pseudo random number generation. Similarly, we can also use for asymmetric ciphers also, because if you take any asymmetric encryption algorithm, it also produces a randomly generated output. So whenever there's some randomness exists, I can use the particular cryptographic algorithm for PRNG also, that is pseudo random number generation. But here, if you are using asymmetric key cryptographic system, the algorithm will be slower than symmetric algorithms because it is highly computational complex. So mostly whenever you need very short PN sequence bit, then only we'll be using the asymmetric encryption algorithm for PN sequence generation. So one of the famous PRNG for asymmetric key cryptographic system is based on RSA algorithm. Okay, so this method is called as Michaelis-Knorr PRNG, which utilizes RSA algorithm for the generation of keys. So I hope you remember RSA algorithm, how it works. In RSA algorithm, we'll be having the public values like N and E are the public keys, and we'll be having a private key called D, kind of stuff, right? Same thing is replaced here with few changes. Okay, so all this encryption bots will be doing the RSA algorithms alone. This is RSA algorithms encryption part. No need of decryption, only encryption is enough. So here you can able to see it is getting two inputs. One is called a seed value. A seed value X naught is like similar to your plain text in your RSA algorithm. Instead of plain text, here we are using a seed value, and here we are using the public keys N and E. And they're using two different variables called R and K. This R and K will be utilized at the end. So for computation, this N, E, and X naught is enough. So this is your plain text, and these are your public keys. So that your ciphertext is nothing but your Y1, which is nothing but X power E mod N. I hope you remember the point there. The ciphertext is nothing but the plain text, which we'll get, which will be resistant to the public key here, mod N. This is the RSA algorithm, how it works. So instead of plain text P, we are having the seed value X naught and E and mod N. So this will produce some output called Y1. This Y1 have some N number of bits, right? Among this Y1, I will take K most significant bits, that is K number of bits. That's why these values K and R are specified here. So this will be given as input. The K most significant bits will be taken as an output called Z1, which is nothing but my PN sequence number, first sequence of PN sequence. Okay, then I will take R most significant bits, next R number of bits as H1, which will be given as a seed value for my second round. Second round seed value is nothing but the R most significant bits of the previous output. This will again get the same input N, E, R, and K, which will again give me Y2. The Z2 is nothing but my second PN sequence bit. And again, the second R most bits will be taken as well next round. So this will be repeated until you satisfy requirement of a sequence, how much big sequence of scenario numbers is required. This is how your PRNG will be working out based on RSA algorithm. Anyone have any doubts in this one? You can ask me. If it is clear, you can raise your hands. So as far as PRNG is concerned, concept is enough. We won't have any numericals in the pseudo random sequential data. Is it clear, guys? If it is clear, raise your hands. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Thank you, guys. So what have we just discussed, this point here. And also, there is also another PRNG which is based on elliptical cryptography, but it is not commercially available. It is only used in US National Security Agency, which has highly sophisticated systems which can able to perform this elliptical cryptography, computationally very strong, and it requires more computational power. It's also called as dual elliptical PRNG, called DEC, dual elliptical PRNG. This one, just for your information, right? So with this, we are concluding your module 4. So if you take your module 4, you'll be having Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm. Then you have your LGAML. I'm saying all the numericals which will avail, which will be coming for your CAT and FAT. Then your common elliptical cryptography. Then ECC based LGAML. Right. So in this module, you'll get numericals only from these things. Okay. And your PRNG will be a theory or conceptual oriented one. Fine. So this, if you prepare this one, then you have well versed with your module 4. Fine, guys. If it is clear, I mean, what I just said now regarding the structure of it, module 4, raise hands. So then I'll directly go into LGAML system. I just collected certain practice problems because we don't have much numericals in books also for LGAML. Okay. LGAML based ECC, we have few things. Okay, so start off with, I will go with, I'll supply certain data so that I hope you people have the formula with you now for LGAML system. So first numerical, so that I'll guide you. I want everyone to use the calculator and tell me the answer. I'm giving you the prime number P to be 11. I'm going with very, very small numbers now for your understanding. Okay. And your one of your public key E1 is 2. Okay. And your private key will be 8. And the secret known one and only to the transmitter R is 9. Okay. These are the data which will be given during examination. And the plain text will take it as message column. Okay, is 5. Fine. Now we have to start solving. First step, in the sense, we have to get all the public keys required. So public keys are E1, E2, and P. So we have only E1, so we have to compute E2. So I hope you remember the formula for E2 is nothing but E1, right? E1 power D mod P. So in this case, it is 2 power 8 mod 11. Can anyone tell the answer? You can post in chat box or you can unmute and tell. 3. Perfect. Next, now we got the values of our public keys P, E1 and E2. Right. Now I'm going for my ciphertext generation. C1 is nothing but your E1 power R mod P, and your C2 nothing but E2 power R, which will be multiplied with the plain text again. I mean, in this case, it's a message column with mod P. So E1 power R, E1 is 2, R is 9, right? Mod 11, we'll get some answer. And C2, E2 power R, E2 is nothing but your 3, so 3 power 9, which will multiply the message called 5, again mod 11. Can anyone tell the answers for C1 and C2? It's very simple. Already computed 2 power 8. Simply add compute 2 power 9.
6.
Yeah, C1 assets, C2.
Nine.
C2 is 9. Okay. Now we should go for decryption part. So there are two ways we can able to perform the decryption. One way is something that you can go with C1 multiplied with C2. I think I'm correct. C2 multiplied with C1 power D, the whole inverse mod P, or you can go with C2 multiply with C1 power P minus 1 minus D mod P. In examination, you can choose anyone, but my kind advice, you can go with the second method, which will save the time for calculating your multiplicate inverse. If it numbers are big, to calculate multiplicate inverse, you have to spend more time. So I want everyone to solve this one. Just solve. This one, let me know what is the answer you're getting. I don't know whether the 6 and 9 are correct, actually. So you have to solve and you have to get the, we are playing test. There is a message, m is equal to 5 as answer. If it is, if you're not getting, then some part is wrong. So C2 is nothing but 9, right? And you have all the answers. If you're, what is the answer if you're getting, just post it in the chat box. That is the decryption option. Yes, Ajay, your C2 value is 9. Okay, fine. I just now saw the chat box. Once you get the plain text, just post PT or P is equal to what is the answer. Use any one method. My best option, I'll always go with this one. I'm not forcing you that you have to choose this one, but my preference is this one. Plus 11 minus 1 minus 8, it will be easy for you. Yes, Rishabh. So you are getting the answer as fine. People are yet to solve, try to solve. So that I'll give the next numerical. Next numerical, I'm not going to guide you step by step. I want everyone to just post the answers alone. Right. So, second problem, I'll just give the data here itself. Your P. This is P is 71, slightly bigger numbers. E1 is 33, and the D is 62. So you have to compute your E2, and your value of R secret is 31, and the message is 15. So first step, tell me the values for E2. After finding E2, tell me the values of C1 and C2. Put it in the chat box. If you complete the first numerical, kindly go with the second one. First, post the answer for E2. We have the formulas here to compute the values of E2. It will take some time because the numbers are big, so it will take some time. If you have any doubts or any clarity, if you require, you can ask me. Okay, number of problems. Because if you are well versed with this one, means then it surely you can easily score 10 marks in module 4. E2 is 10. Okay. Anyone getting any different answer, you can post E2. We want it to be 10. Yes, Surya, Ajay, both got. Okay, you proceed with your C1 and C2. Yes. E2 is 10, perfect, correct. Once you get the answer for C1 and C2, at least if you get C1, post for C1 first, then you can post for C2. Hope it plus solving. C1 you got 62, C2 18. Okay. Yes, Ajay, you're correct. Anyone having any different answer? Let me know. So that if you find the decryption means you should get the plain text back. Yes, Rishabh. Perfect. C1 is true. So anyone getting any different answer for C1 and C2? Once if you have solved the plain text, decryption part, just let me know whether you're getting the same answer or not. That's right. Rishabh, have you solved for C2? Getting the answer? 18? Okay, you're getting 15. Okay, then the answers are perfect. Okay, guys, I hope now you are comfortable with LLM, right? So anyone have any doubts, you can ask. If you are comfortable, can you raise hands with the LLM system or the entire module for any doubts or anything? Then we will wrap up today's session so that we'll start our next module on next class. Okay, thank you, guys. Thank you.